Hello, you're watching Proactive London. I'm joined by David Minchin. He's the chairman of HeLIX Exploration. David, very good to speak with you again.
Nice to speak to you too.
So David, you've just listed the company on the AIM markets in London. Congratulations. Before we get into that though, tell us more about HeLIX Exploration.
Yes, very excited to be talking to you on our first day of trading. HeLIX Exploration is a new company looking for helium in Montana. It's a brownfield project, a very large domed closure in Montana called the Ingomar Dome, which extends over 16,500 acres with a P50 resource of 2.3 billion cubic feet and an upside of over 6 billion cubic feet. It's been substantially de-risked by historical drilling, which I really like. There's identified gas on every single one of our target reservoir horizons. That gas has been tested. We've got 195 foot in the Amsden formation, which is the topmost closure. We've got 175 foot in the Charles formation, which is the middle reservoir. And we've got 10 to 26 foot in the flathead formation, which is the main producing reservoir along this entire flathead fairway. All this points to a really exciting start of year as we move into drilling it in Q3 of this year, and we're targeting first production before the end of 2025.
David, you obviously have investors excited as well because your IPO was massively oversubscribed. You raised £7.5 million, giving you a market cap of around £12 million, but you could have raised a lot more.
Yes, you're absolutely right. We went out to raise between £3.5 to £5 million. We actually ended up with a book of demand of over 22 million, which we took 7.5, basically to minimize dilution to the existing shareholders and to ensure there was plenty of interest on the secondary market. The biggest shareholder is the chief executive, Mr. Bo Sears, who is the founder of the company and a well-known expert in the helium space. He spent 25 years exploring and developing helium projects around the United States. He's taken projects from discovery through development into production in the past, and he's put his own money into securing these leases here in Montana. But we're very, very excited. You know, London is a great place to be listing a company. There's lots of investors who are already very aware of the helium story and the macroeconomics behind the helium commodity space. We've received a lot of interest.
David, so how will you put the money raised to good use as you advance the project?
Well, obviously keeping a very tight grip of G&A, but also maintaining an aggressive timeline. Montana's a really easy state for operation because it's been a long history of oil and gas exploration there. So there's rigs available. All the service providers are already operating in the state. And that makes it a much cheaper place to operate. So we're looking at about $2.5 million to drill and test an appraisal well. We're looking to drill that in Q3 and then do an extended flow test, a 30-day flow test with lots of results coming out as we go from wireline to testing our reservoir horizons and you know, getting those all-important helium grades and the flow rates. We're then able to fast track from the data from the appraisal well can feed into detailed engineering and plant construction, which we'd be looking to complete throughout 2025 to target first gas production before the end of 2025.
David, take us through the dynamics you're seeing for the helium markets at the moment and how you're going to be positioned for that at HeLIX Exploration.
Well, to look at the dynamics of the helium market, you just need to look at the helium price. You know, there's been a series of supply crises over the last 20 years, which has resulted in a CAGR price increase of 20% over the last decade. We're seeing import pricing into China between $500 and $600 per MCF. We're seeing end users in the United States paying a lot more. So for instance, in November of 22, we saw NASA signing a 5-year deal for 1.2 billion cubic feet priced at $920 per MCF. And the US Defense Logistics Agency, which buys all of the helium for the US Army, they're paying now $1,080 per MCF. Obviously, that's for all different types of package size, but it demonstrates that people are paying a premium for helium supply, which is especially important in the United States, where with the introduction of the CHIPS Act, we'll see a lot of the should see increased demand, as a lot of the chips manufacturing, the semiconductor manufacturing and computer chips work, which is currently happening in East Asia, is going to be brought onshore onto the United States, increasing domestic demand, which an operation in Montana is ideally located to feed both the East Coast and the West Coast of the United States.
David, short-term milestones that your investors and your new investors should be looking out for?
Yes, there's a lot happening. So we're going to kick off with a scoping study. The results of it should be available in this quarter. Drilling in Q3, so there's the build-up to that with the civils work, of contracting of the rig. Obviously, when the spudding and the drilling itself, wireline results, extended flow test, a 30-day flow test. There'll be a very busy two-month period while we go through the drilling and the testing. And then, of course, all that feeds directly into construction. We're also hoping to use a certain portion of the oversubscribed funds that we raise to secure other pipeline projects focused around the Montana Helium Fairway, so we can have a pipeline of near-term, near production, low-risk exploration assets to really grow a meaningful, medium-sized new helium supplier to the North American market.
Well, David, I hope you'll keep us posted on any progress. Congratulations again on the IPO today.
Thank you very much.
That's David Minchin, the chairman of HeLIX Exploration.